to understand the basic properties of semiconductors . First, we have to look into their crystal structures. In this lecture, we will see the structures of elemental semiconductors. We know that elemental semiconductors like silicon, germanium belong to group 4 of the periodic table. Both of these elements have the same or similar diamond-like structure. Here we will see the structure formation for silicon and by using same methods we can make the structure for germanium. For understanding of the structure I am assuming a pure crystal of silicon without Any impurities? Of any kind. Like dislocations, and other. First, let's see the electronic configuration of silicon. We know that electronic configuration of silicon is neon, three S two and three P two. We can think these outer electrons as there are two electrons in 3s orbital and two electrons. We can mark it as 3s, and these orbitals belong to 3p. That is, this one is px, py, and pz. We can consider these as psi 3s orbital, psi px, psi py, and psi pz orbitals. For a single silicon atom, the electronic configuration looks like this one. But when other silicon atoms come close to this atom, then due to closeness of the energy between these 3s and 3p electrons, hybridization will take place. So due to that hybridization, the electronic configuration of all the silicon atoms will become like this. So after hybridization, the electronic configuration of silicon becomes as, so now after hybridization this will become like 3s1 and 3p3. That is, we can think it as this is 3s and this is 3p. So now one electron is in this orbital and all these orbitals can have one electron each. So now all these orbitals आर नोन एज हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स, हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स एंड all hybrid orbitals have equal energy. So we can denote these orbitals, I mean hybrid orbitals, as psi hybrid. So now we can denote these all these as psi. This one is psi hybrid and these also. Since all these orbitals are have similar energy, so we can denote by a single symbol. Now these hybrid, now these hybrid orbitals come close to each other and make covalent bond by sharing of these electrons. So if I consider only the outer or valence electron, let's say these orbitals for a single atom and these similar hybrid orbitals for other atom. And when they come close to each other, then they will form a covalent bond by sharing of these electrons. And we can see now all these orbitals are half filled. So after making a bond, these molecular orbitals will look like these. Now these orbitals will fully occupy and there is no electron in these orbitals. So these orbitals are known as bonding orbitals. And the unoccupied orbitals आर नोन एज एंटी बॉन्डिंग ऑर्बिटल्स। एंड फॉर ए सिंगल एटम वी कैन थिंक सिलिकन एज दिस इज द न्यूक्लियस ऑफ सिलिकन एंड वी कैन कंसिडर फोर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स और फोर वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अराउंड दिस न्यूक्लियस लाइक दिस। And this single atom will make covalent bond to other atoms like this. Now we can think another silicon atom here. This is the covalent bond between this atom and this atom. We can see another atom here. Similarly, this is another atom. So now in this way we can complete the structure of the silicon. This is a 2D pattern of the silicon structure, but in 3D if we take a single atom, a tetrahedral is formed. If we and in reality or in three dimension, a tetrahedral is formed. Like this. And by using this tetrahedral, we can complete the diamond structure. And if we see now, these bonding orbitals get stabilization, and due to this stabilization there is a gap between these states and these states. So if we make an energy band diagram of the silicon, then we can think this is the valence band as we know. Due to bonding orbitals, and we can see these orbitals are fully filled, and this band is known as conduction band. Due to antibonding orbitals, This edge of the valence band is known as EV, or we can denote is by EV. And lower part of conduction band can be denoted by EC. And this gap, that is, if I denote it as EZ, which is equal to EC minus EV, is known as band gap. Of the material. Here I am using silicon, so this is the band gap for silicon, and we note for silicon the band gap is 1.1 electron volt. So at zero temperature, the crystal of silicon is perfect and there is no electrons in the conduction band. But as we increase the temperature, and by increasing of the temperature, there are atomic vibrations, and due to these vibrations, some bonds can be broken, and due to these breaking of bonds, some electrons get energy and go to this conduction band. We will study this in the later part of this course, but here we have to only think about these crystal structures and how these crystal structure form in silicon or germanium. And by using this same method, we can form the crystal structure for germanium. And if we make a vacuum level here, I can write it I vacuum, then the difference between EC and EVAC is known as electron affinity. That is denoted by this xi, which is equal to EVAC minus EC, which is known as electron affinity. This is very important term, and we will use this term many times. So by rotating this tetrahedral, we can make a complete structure like diamond. So we can make diamond structure by using this tetrahedral, or we can understand diamond structure like this. If we make first tetrahedral, now we can connect other tetrahedral to these points. If we connect one here, one here, one here, similarly this atom here, here, so this belong to this parallel here. Again we can consider this as initial point. In this way we can complete the diamond structure. And on other way, we can also think diamond structure by using two FCC structures or FCC unit cell. We know that for FCC, atoms are present on the corners, 8 corners, and as well as on the 6 faces. So, by interpenetrating of other FCC unit cell to this body diagonal, we can make diamond structure. And for this, there will be 4 extra atoms in this unit cell. First one is here, that is connected to this atom, and this atom, and this one. So there we can see here 4 atoms are connected. So in this way, this tetrahedral is formed, and other atom will be at here, that is at 1/4 position. This is also connected to this atom, this atom, back side of the face, and again this is connected to 3 other atoms. Third one will come here, and fourth one will come here. So in this way, this diamond like structure is formed. And we know that packing factor for diamond structure is equal to 34%. You can study it in deeply in solid state physics. And we also know that the nearest neighbor distance, that is known as 2r, which is equal to √3a/4, where a is the lattice constant, which is equal to 8r/√3, and this is nearest neighbor distance. So in this way, we study the simple crystal structure of silicon. And in this structure, we know that a silicon atom is bonded covalently by 4 other silicon atoms, and this bonding of silicon looks like a tetrahedral. And by using the same method, we can make the crystal structure for germanium. And in next lectures, we will see the crystal structure for compound semiconductor.